Welcome to our Windows 7 Beginner to Advanced video training series. Today, we will cover some more useful features of Wordpad. Chapter 2, Lesson 1, Part 2, Microsoft Wordpad. For our today's lesson, I'm going to create another document, so you can understand the commands better. In today's lesson, you are going to see and learn many interesting facts, which you may have not considered before. So, stay tuned with me, as I am typing out today's exercise. Formatting a document is not just about increasing the font size or change font, or using bold, italics, or alignments. I am typing this exercise in front of you, because there are a lot more things, which you should consider in your mind, while drafting a document. So, for today's lesson, the first thing you should remember that, never press enter key in the end of a line, while typing a paragraph. A paragraph means a continuous sequence of words without any break. Pressing enter key means that, you are telling the Wordpad, to insert a break, and this is the end of the line, and I want to start a new line or, a new paragraph. This is the biggest mistake, which normally the novice user do. They check in the ruler that the page is going to end, so they press enter key to move to the next line. Do remember that, pressing enter means, you are telling the application that, this is the end of the paragraph, and you are starting a new paragraph. So, later when you will apply formatting on these lines, Wordpad will assume them as separate lines or separate paragraphs. All the word processor applications assume enter key as the beginning of a new paragraph. Here, I have typed two paragraphs as an example. In first paragraph, I have pressed enter key in the end of each line of the paragraph, whereas, the second paragraph is in continuous form, and have only one enter in the end of the paragraph. Now, let's see how the formatting will work differently on both of the paragraphs and what kind of difficulties you can experience. The first fact you should notice between these paragraphs is the line spacing. Do note down the line spacing in the first paragraph and then the following paragraph. If you click on the line spacing button, in the paragraph section, do note down the default settings. There is a check mark on two items. The first one is line spacing 1.15, and the second is add 10 point space after paragraphs. Now, what is happening in our first paragraph is, Wordpad is assuming every line of the first paragraph as an individual paragraph. So that is why, it is adding a 10-point extra space to each line. Whereas, the second paragraph only has a spacing of 1.15 in every line because, it has written continuously without any enter between lines. The second fact is, justifying the paragraph. In our previous exercise, I had explained you about left, center, and right alignments, but I did not give any information about the fourth alignment option, which is justify. This is because the justify command only applies to paragraphs, not on individual lines. Now, we have two paragraphs, let's see how justify command works. If I select the second paragraph and then click on justify command, notice that the paragraph has been perfectly aligned from the right side. Both the left and right side of the paragraph are now equally aligned. This is what justify command is for. Justify command automatically add extra spacing between words to align the paragraph from right side. Now, let's apply the justify command to our first paragraph. You can see that even after applying the command, nothing is happening. As I told you before that the justify command only applies to paragraphs, and this is not a paragraph but four different lines. Let's see the third fact about paragraphs. Now, I select the second paragraph again and increase font size. You can notice that Wordpad is automatically adjusting the lines and paragraph. If I do the same to our first paragraph, then see what happens? As I increase the size to 14, the paragraph gets imprecise and you have broken lines in between the paragraphs. The lines get separated from the same location, where you had pressed enter key. You were not noticing this before, because the font size was smaller. As soon as you increase the size, you can clearly see the line breaks. The last and interesting fact about paragraphs is indents. In my previous lesson, we had discussed about indents, and how you can efficiently use them, instead of tabs and spaces. You can also apply indents to paragraphs. Suppose, I want to have, half-inch space in the second paragraph, then I can easily accomplish this by, selecting the paragraph, and clicking on increase indent button once. See what happens, when I do the same for our first paragraph. The paragraph again gets broken because of the extra enters, that we have at the end of each line. Now, let's first make our first paragraph exactly as our second paragraph is. To do this, you can remove additional enters, that we have at the end of each line. To remove those enters, just click in the end of each line, and press delete key from your keyboard. This will start adjoining the lines together, and will make this a single paragraph instead of many different lines. You may now have a good idea that how to compose paragraphs. Let's learn the line spacing feature in more comprehensive manners. Line spacing is used to increase the gap between lines, and we do this to make our paragraphs more appealing. If we check the current view of our document, you can see that on a letter size page, if we will take the print out of this page, then there is a lot of uncovered area at the bottom of the page, or you can say that half of the page is blank. To cover some more area, we can increase the spacing between lines. To do this, just select the lines or paragraphs, and choose an appropriate spacing, that you think will be nice for your document. You can also add or remove spacing between paragraphs by adding a 10 pints space between paragraphs. So, I am choosing 2 as line spacing and also checking add 10 point space after paragraphs. Now, let's see the preview and you can notice that our text is now covering more space on the page. The next option that we are going to learn is indents. We have already discussed about indents in our previous lesson, but let's see the other features of indents. As discussed in previous chapter, you can increase or decrease indents, using buttons available in paragraph section. But those buttons only increase the left indent, means you can only increase the left indent through those buttons. But, in Wordpad, there are total 3 types of indents available. The first one is left indent, second is right indent, and third one is, first line indent. Looking carefully at the ruler, you can see that we have sliders available. In the first look, they seems to be 2 sliders, but they are actually 3, which are, first line indent, left indent and then right indent. In Wordpad, you can even manually adjust the indents through those sliders. To do this, just select the paragraphs, and move the sliders. If you move the first line indent slider, note that the first line of both paragraphs is moving along with the slider. This is an easy way to increase the spacing of first line, for every paragraph in your document. This will save the hassle of, pressing additional spaces or tabs. You can also adjust the left indent through both the buttons, and the slider available in your ruler. But there is a difference in both ways. If you decide to increase the left indent through buttons available in your paragraph, then do note that it will increase or decrease, a default half-inch space every time you press the button. Whereas, through ruler, you can move the left indent, to the desired location, you want. The third type of indent is, right indent. The right indent is used to increase the spacing from the right side of the page, without pressing enter key. Means, if you do not want to be your paragraph so long in the width, then you can reduce the width, just by increasing the right indent. This is another reason that why mostly people press enter key, to shorten their paragraphs, which is wrong. Whenever, you need to shorten your paragraph from the right side, just select your paragraph and increase the right indent. You can also change the left, right, first line indent, line spacing, and alignment through a single button. This button is called paragraph, is available under paragraph section of home tab. Just select your paragraphs, and click this button, and you can change all the settings in a single click. Before we continue with our lesson, let's first save our document, and type a name. Always do remember the location where you are going to save your document. The default location is, My Documents. Before I finish this lesson, let me give you some information about page margins. Page margins are the blank area on all four sides of your page, which you see in the print preview window. You can adjust the margins as per your contents. Say, you want to print your current document on a pre-printed letterhead, and that letterhead is covering almost 3.5 inches of area of page from top. So, what we will do is to open Page Setup window from WordPad menu. Here you can see the predefined margins. Those are the default margins for every new document you create in WordPad. So, here we change the top margin to 3.5 inches. Now, let's see the preview. Here you can note that we have now 3.5 margins on the top of our document. That means, when you will take a printout either on a blank page or on a letterhead, your print will skip 3.5 inches page blank from top. With the same way, you can define margins for other three sides of your page, as desire. Finally, let me clear you the difference between margins and indents. When you change the margin of your document, then do remember that it will get applied to all the pages of your current document. Suppose, if I change the right margin to 2 inches and apply the changes, you can notice the gray area in the ruler from the right side has increased and all the contents of our page have adjusted. But the indents work only on your selection. Means you can apply different indent settings for different paragraphs. In our next lesson, I will provide you some more detailed information about margins. We will also cover more features of WordPad in our next part of WordPad Full Overview. Till then, have a nice day and thanks for watching. Keep sharing our videos and subscribe to our channel for more upcoming videos.